Vancouver Point Grey.
You know, Honourable Speaker, you just have to look at the record to understand the problems with what the minister is saying. It was May of last year when the doctors and nurses that were frontline went to the media and said this system was producing medication errors that were putting patients at risk. It was November of last year. This minister's own report that he commissioned said that this computerized provider order entry system be, quote, revalidated, unquote, to ensure it was safe. And yet, where are we now? This minister has shut down the system Friday of last week. My question to the minister, Honourable Speaker, how many patients were put at risk and were any patients injured?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Well, Honourable Speaker, the system has not been taken down. There are physicians, 112 members of the Medical Staff Association, I believe there are 175 members in total, that still had some concerns and asked for the computerized provider order entry system to be put aside while that revalidation occurs. Honourable Speaker, Dr. Cochrane did not recommend that. Other experts have not recommended that. But we are going to walk through what that process looks like with the Medical Staff Association and the members of the healthcare team in Nanaimo, because if that is the best thing to do, we will do it, but we will ensure that that process does not endanger patient safety, and we will walk together in a collaborative way to accomplish our goal of a one electronic health record for every patient.
Member for Vancouver Point Grey on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, whether the minister says that the system was put aside or shut down, the fact is that doctors and nurses are going back to pen and paper because they said from the very beginning that this system is not safe for patients. And when they said that, the minister said to them, quote, I don't have a concern about the structural integrity of this system. And then after he got the audit, he hedged a little bit, quote, no one is doing this to a level that they were hoping to get with this, so this will all get us to a better place, unquote. But we're not in a better place, Honourable Speaker. The doctors and nurses are still worried about patient safety, and the minister and his experts can say there's no problem, but the people treating patients say there are medication errors taking place. So again to the minister, how many patients were put at risk, and were any patients injured?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. And the member, as is, he is wont to do, is putting words in my mouth. I did not say that Dr. Cochrane or other experts said that there was no problems with the system. Honourable Speaker, they recognized that there were challenges with the system, but they did not recommend putting it aside while those revalidation processes occurred. Honourable Speaker, the reality is that people working at Nanaimo, a large number of people, significant number, still don't have the confidence that is necessary to go forward with the system. And so we will walk with them to look at the process of setting aside the system and discover to what extent that will affect patient care. We're going to do it in a collaborative, cooperative way, Honourable Speaker. And, you know, the member I know can think back to other challenges in electronic systems around the world. This is a challenge, Honourable Speaker, but we shouldn't be daunted by challenges. We shouldn't give up. We need to get to an electronic health record that provides a single patient record for the safety and effective care of delivery in the province of British Columbia.